Technical education institution in India should focus on the emerging challenges. So technical education institution should focus on the emerging, challenging, and the changing environment, changing scope of the things. So we must focus on quality, access and equality. So in India is full of a lot of younger people compared to any other Western countries. So we must use the power of the youth by leveraging with them proper education. So we have 106 technically centrally funded technical institutions. Kitna 106 centrally funded technical institutions. So if we see, we have more than 1,000 universities, 42,000 colleges, and 11,000 standalone institutions. And we're talking about these 106 centrally funded technical institutions. So there's a need to be accountable. So we need to look at the current as well as future challenges. So kya padhana chahiye? We should teach the university to focus on the current and the future challenges. You must educate outstanding, provide outstanding education and motivate them to become outstanding creative thinkers. We must motivate them to become outstanding creative thinkers, innovators and entrepreneurs. So there's a lot of future challenges, the food security, national security, climate change, the energy security. There's a lot of demanding challenges. So if we want to lead a country as a technology advanced country, so there's a need of technical institution. So there's a greater need for our technical institution to adopt and change themselves. So there's a new challenge emerging every day. So our educational institution should be adapted to these change, should not be static. So their education institution should be dynamic. Quality education should come down from top to bottom. So everybody get the quality education, even the not only IITs, but other education institutions should also focus on providing quality education to the students. And they can compete with IIT in terms of quality. So we must have ensured the atmosphere of healthy competition. So even the students who cannot qualify through the exams like this IIT exam, they get competitive. Should not feel disheartened and discouraged because they cannot get into IIT. We must create an atmosphere of competition so that the people of other colleges can also learn from the IITs. So now there is a students exchange program between the foreign and Indian IITs. Between the foreign education institution IIT. So in the same kind of exchange program can happen where the IITians can come and teach and a person from lower education institution can go and learn from the IITs. So we must increase and encourage the capability of our education institution and should give equally importance to co-curricular activities and education. And the institution should reinvent and reevaluate themselves. So the higher education institution, IITs and other education institutions should reinvent and reevaluate themselves according to the need of the hour. We need alternative innovative models according to the country and societal need. So in the present as well as in future. So the students should be the leaders in the society in particular domains. So these institutions has remained there as an island of excellence. So we need to look at the alternative ways of looking at our own institution. We need to reach out some other institutes and university in the country and have collaboration. So IIT should have a collaboration with other institutes in the country. So other institutes can also learn from the top renowned institutions of the country. Because we also have to ensure equality. We cannot produce only a handful of engineers. We must have a huge human resource in our country. So that the standards of both the institutional learning process increase and also research take place in these universities. So there's a heterogeneous thing. So when you integrate a lot of universities together, there is a heterogeneous thinking. And when you put heterogeneous minds together, a lot of creative thinking comes. So we need to harness the diversity of the input we get. There's students who have never seen the village and there's other students who have never seen the city life. There's a student who always speak English. Other students do not even know the English. So there's have a diversity of students. So you must mentor them to be leader in the domain in which they work. So they can, you know, improve on their strength and improve their weakness. So by the time they graduate, they should not be equally proficient only in the technical aspects, but also in the communication. So we must develop an ecosystem of technological education in Indian language. Technological education is more than Indian language. So less than 10% of Indians converse in English. Now more than 90% of Indians use their own Indian language. So if a child is educated, research has shown that if a child is educated in the mother tongue and if it continues to the higher level, they are much more creative compared to who are forced in the early age to study the language. which is not their own mother tongue. So there should be greater emphasis on national international education policy should impart the education in the Indian languages. So the technical education in Indian languages should not be overnight. We can offer in one Indian language. So we can offer certificate diploma programs in emerging areas like machine learning, software engineering, computer science. We do not require the kind of labs which is required in chemical engineering, yeah, mechanical engineering, if you reach in their mother tongue. So if we provide them these kind of skills, we can be employed in the local companies, software companies. So when we talk about this pyramid structure, there's need for them to come out of the island of isolation and reach out to the rest of the country using technology. And this is the greatest opportunity for us because our entire attitude towards the digital education has changed. And this COVID-19 pandemic, indeed a lot of things have changed because of the pandemic. So a lot of have changed because of COVID-19 pandemic. That's why we are talking about the digital education, we are talking about the adaptation, and we are talking about we need to orient our education system towards solving the emerging challenges. So proper infrastructure is a need of that. So IITs are 60 years older. So we need refurbishing and require bigger campus to grow because we have a lot of interdisciplinary things. So education, what we impart to our students should respond to our emerging challenges, and specifically technological education. It should focus on innovation, research and development. So one of the objective of the national education policy is to make higher education as flexible as possible. So internationalization of higher education has been taking long for some time. So it should help our education institution rise their visibility and prestige worldwide. So Kasturi Rangan says education can no longer be the watertight compartment. So what is education? It's the creation of full human potential and developing an equitable and just society, promotion of national development. So new education policy of 2020 try to address the education in the broadest of the framework that the country have to knowledge. We recognize it. And education is the creation of the human potential. We need to develop an equitable and just society for the promotion of national development. Promotion of national development are some of the key element coming out of the education. Propagation of universal access to quality education for global stage leadership. And India aspire to be in terms of economic growth and justice and equality, scientific advancement, national integration and cultural preservation. Scientific advancement, national integration, cultural preservation. So India has one of the largest younger population. We have to cater them in the terms of aspiration, a quality education, keeping the view of the fully 21st century demand. So we focus on the sustainable development goal. So we must provide equitable quality education and promote life learning opportunities for all by 2030. So the world is changing very fast. On the one side, we have got to change in the science and technological side, in particular in the areas like data, big data analysis, machine learning, artificial intelligence. That we need a skilled workforce. It could be in the area of mathematics, it could be in the computer sciences, data sciences, and multidisciplinary sciences. We need a knowledge that will cut across the sciences and humanities, social sciences. So broader approach is needed with respect to that. So we need short-term, long-term, and long-term perspective. Short, medium, and long-term perspective. So how you put system in the education so that there is no commercialization of education?